Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel Being Ananya. And this video is going to be about Q&A of all your comments. I have been reading your comments and I just thought of making a video on it. So here I am with yet another video. So basically this video is going to be about Q&A for Salesforce side. So this is going to be purely about Salesforce question and answers. So I hope I answer all your questions. And I have picked up few comments from my latest video that was regarding Salesforce. And I'll be answering those questions. And don't worry, if your questions are outside of Salesforce, which are related to primers or maybe anything else, there is a video coming up just after this video. So I'll be answering your questions in that. I have selected few questions for this video. तो मैंने ये सोच के सेलेक्ट किया है कि वो सारे उन क्वेश्चंस के आंसर करने से और भी बहुत कमेंट्स के आंसर्स हो जाएं. सो आई हैव जस्ट सेलेक्टेड दोज कमेंट्स व्हिच आई फील एक्चुअली विल सॉल्व मेनी अदर क्वेरीज एज वेल. सो लेट्स गो. तो मैंने ऐसे फटफट से आपके सारे क्वेश्चंस आंसर कर दूंगी बिकॉज एक्चुअली दिस इज माय ऑफिस टाइमिंग. आई एम डूइंग वर्क फ्रॉम होम एंड ये मेरा लंच टाइम है. सो आई जस्ट क्विकली रैप दिस अप एंड गो टू वर्क. सो यस, ऐसे फटफट आंसर्स करते हैं सारे क्वेश्चंस. ओके, सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, आई रिसेंटली कंप्लीटेड माय सेल्सफोर्स सर्टिफिकेशन फॉर एडमिन. डू आई हैव टू टेक प्राइमर एंड स्ट्रीम ट्रेनिंग और विल आई बी डायरेक्टली पुट इनटू प्रोजेक्ट? सो फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन, okay, so there are two ways for this. If you have completed your certification and if you have done training beforehand, that is before the certification, agar Accenture ne aapko training karwai thi, just like in my case from Smart Interns platform. So basically aapne training bhi kar li Smart Interns se and then certification bhi. Then you don't need to appear for any stream training or primers after onboarding. But there's a but. If you fall into second case type, which is if you have just completed the certification and till now there is no training that you took, then after onboarding you might have to actually take stream training and you might have to actually take primers as well as stream training. So basically there are two ways जितना मुझे पता चला. फर्स्ट वे वॉज ऑफ माई टाइप. वॉट हैपन्ड विद मी वॉज, यू कैन वॉच दिस वीडियो ओवर हियर एज वेल. वॉट वॉज माई जर्नी वॉज दैट आई एक्चुअली अपीयर्ड फॉर ट्रेनिंग फॉर 2 to 3 months, विच वॉज हेल्ड बाय एक्सेंचर ओनली थ्रू स्मार्ट इंटर्न्स प्लेटफॉर्म. आफ्टर दैट आई अपीयर्ड फॉर माई सर्टिफिकेशन एग्जामिनेशन एंड बिकॉज वी वर सर्टिफाइड सो वी वर एबल टू ऑन बोर्ड एंड वी डिड नॉट अपीयर फॉर प्राइमर्स और स्ट्रीम ट्रेनिंग. बट इफ यू फॉल इनटू सेकंड कैटेगरी, विच इज इफ यू हैव जस्ट कम्प्लीटेड द सर्टिफिकेशन, have not done any training or anything, then might be there is a high chance that you will have to appear for primers and stream training in Salesforce only. So these are the possible case scenarios. Again, I'm saying possible case scenarios because there are many scenarios. Honestly telling you, बहुत तरीके से यहाँ पे onboarding होती है, नहीं होती है. There are many ways कि कभी stream training हो रही होती है, नहीं हो रही होती. That's why I'm stating this as possible scenarios. So I hope I solved your query. Okay, so the next question is, how you prepare to clear the PD1 exam? So basically, I attended the training Smart Interns platform, which was through Accenture only. So that was helpful in my learning journey. Secondly, I did Trailheads. So basically, Trailheads helps a lot when you do hands-on. So basically, they help a lot in logic building, in your understanding. So that helped. And see, I understand there are few dumps. So you can refer to dumps as well for clearing the examination. But I would like to advise that prefer doing hands-on because at the end of the day you'll have to understand the concept pura jaise bhi hota hai. So yeah, that is it. बहुत ज्ञान की बातें हो गई. बट हाँ, आप डम्स प्रेफर कर सकते हैं. सो ऑन एंड ऑन, मतलब एज एन इट्स गुड इफ आप अपना कॉन्सेप्ट बिल्ड करो, क्योंकि अभी नहीं तो आपको कल तो कॉन्सेप्ट बिल्ड करना ही पड़ेगा. सो या, दैट्स इट. ऑन टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. So I can see a question. यहाँ पे I have been allocated to Salesforce developer domain. So how will it be? Can you tell more information regarding this? I think I've shared my experience. You can watch this video. And for Salesforce developer, I am Salesforce developer. तो developer में आपका पूरा dev role आता है. Everything, coding, configuration, admin work, it consists of everything. If that is what you're asking. If you're asking something else, then please let me know because this is all I could gather from your question. after clearing the PD1 certification, in how many days you got onboarding mail? हमको याद नहीं आ रहा यार, एक सेकेंड. सो आई थिंक PD1 सर्टिफिकेशन मेरा हो गया था अगस्त में. यस, इन अगस्त. एंड ऑन बोर्डिंग मेल आई गॉट इन आई थिंक सेप्टेम्बर. सो या आई थिंक श्योर बहुत ज्यादा आ रहा है. होप इट इज नॉट दैट इरिटेटिंग. सॉरी फॉर दैट. ओके, सो आई कैन सी मेनी रिपीटेड क्वेश्चन. जैसे इट इज बाय वन मोर पर्सन that after having completing SFDC global certification, do we need to undergo any Salesforce training? I've already answered this. I hope that please clear my doubt, Ananya. So I've already answered it. I hope you're clear. Please let me know agar aapko aur doubt ho. So again, can you tell is there or not training after onboarded in Salesforce domain, after onboarding in Salesforce domain? So yes, as I mentioned that it depends if you fall into case one or case two. So if you fall into case two, of course you'll have to go through stream training. But if you have already cleared the examination, already selected Salesforce beforehand, did training beforehand for onboarding, then of course why would you do training two times? चलिए देखते हैं कोई और क्वेश्चन अगर बाकी हो तो. Can you share your PD1 exam experience? Can I share? No. Just kidding. So, PD1 exam experience, I think मैंने बताया भी है अपने उस वीडियो में that actually one of the very, I must say, the proctoring was very, you know, hard because even eye movements वो ले रहा था. So I could not vigorously move my eye from question to even submit button because it was showing up that there is vigorous movement. So yeah, it was quite difficult, but I think yeah, it is worth it. It contains a certain value, that's why hence the strictness. So yeah, because someone has asked me, Didi, how to contact you. I have several doubts regarding Salesforce. Ab yahan karo comment section mein yaar, koi tension wali baat nahi hai. Bindaas poocho. So aap pooche jo bhi aapko doubt ho, I'll be more than happy to help. I mean, jitna main kar sakungi, I'll try to help. Okay, so the last question for the day is, I am enrolled in Salesforce certification from Accenture, but I'm not interested in this program and don't want to give the certification exam. Will it affect my onboarding? So, I think you need to contact HR or whosoever is the point of contact POC, because you'll have to inform them kya jo koi bhi ho aapke person in contact ki aapko nahi karna hai ye aage pursue, and then I think they will be the suitable person to guide you better. So I hope I cleared your doubts. And अभी time हो चुका है, my break is also over, so I'll get back to work and you get back to your whatever process you're doing. So yeah, have a good day. Toodles. Yeah, and one more thing, I'll be uploading my office log soon, so that will help you to understand the culture and way more things better. So I hope that helps you too, and I hope this helps you as well. So stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe.